Now, mostly, we're looking for correct code. And if you wrote some more tests, you may start to have some more confidence in the code that we have. But we're also considered efficiency to some degree. And it seems like there's a big problem with the efficiency of the program we have so far. Let me show you one of the issues. Now, we represented states as a here, there, t triplet. And the problem with this is there can be two states that have identical here and theirs, but differ in the t, and they're going to be considered different states. Now, why is that a problem? Consider this problem. We have two people, one who takes 1 unit to cross the bridge, and one who takes 1,000. Now, it seems pretty clear there's an easy solution. The two of them go across together, and it takes 1,000. But look how we're going to explore this space. We're going to start out in the initial state that took time 0, and then we're going to start adding things to the frontier. And out of all the ways we could cross, the one that adds the least is for the one to go across by himself, and now he's on the other side with the one on the other side and the 1,000 on the original slide, and that only took 1 step. And now what's the fastest thing we can do after that? Well, we can take 1 more step and go back to the original state. So here we had 1, and we'll say, we'll call K for the 1,000 on the left-hand side. Here, K was left behind, and 1 went over to the right. Here, we took 1 more time unit, and we had 1 and K on this side. And if we continue taking the fastest step we can, we'll get to another distinct state where K is on this side and 1 is on the other side, and the flashlight's always going with the 1. So we keep on going on like that. We'll go out 1,000 different steps. And each of these will be a distinct state because this will be the state with time t equals 0, here time t equals 1, t equals 2, t equals 3. But really, although it looks like we're getting different states, in another way of looking at it, we're always getting the same state. We're just going back and forth from here to there and back to here and back and back. We're going around in circles. So in order to recognize that these are in fact the same states, we're going to have to take t out of our state, and we're going to have to deal with the t someplace else. So we want our representation of a state to be just here and there, and we got to figure out someplace else to put the t, and I'm not sure what the right way to do it is, but why don't we do it this way? We have a path, which is state, action, state, dot, dot, dot. Keeps on alternating between states and actions. Let's change that so that the path is a state followed by a tuple of the action and the total time it took after applying that action, then the next state, then the next action, and the total time after applying that, and so on. So that'll be our new representation. States are going to look like that, and paths are going to look like that. Now, I want you to write the new successor function for the bridge problem. So we'll call it bSuccessors2, the 2 just to keep it distinct from the first version. And again, it returns a dict of state-action pairs. A state now is just a 2-tuple of a here and a there, and the here and there are still frozen sets. So it's pretty much the same, except we dropped out the time t. Go ahead and implement that for me.